Jessica Romano of Carnegie Museum of Natural History, and today I'm talking to Dr. Rosemarie Musica, Director of Science and Research. Rosemarie, this museum has 22 million objects, specimens, fossils, artifacts. Tell me a little bit about what it means to be Director of Science and Research and how you manage all that.
It is daunting, overwhelming, extremely exciting, like any adjective, any modifier you can apply would be accurate. Because of the magnitude, as you point out, 22 million specimens, because of the diversity in our disciplines, right? Mm-hmm. There are 18 scientists here. They all do something different. So it's a really different type of science leadership position, because I don't know what everyone does, but I'm trying to learn, and I can't, of course, learn it all. So I have a great deal of excitement every time I interact with the curator and appreciation for what they do, and I'm in awe of them. So it's a challenge, right, to keep track of things. Like during the course of a day, I'd be talking to one curator, working with people in one section, and 5 minutes later, another one, and so my mind is like constantly engaged, which I think is kind of healthy, especially as you get older. So it's really exciting, scary, and busy, but it's kind of an awe-inspiring opportunity too.
Oh, that's wonderful. Mm-hmm. Tell me a little bit about what day-to-day looks like for you.
Mm-hmm. Well, during the time of COVID, it's a little bit different, as you would expect. Here in the museum, I try to have some face-to-face, mask-to-mask meetings with scientists when they're around, but most of my interaction with scientists now is virtual. Just keeping up with what they're doing research-wise, talking with collection managers, going to collections when I'm here, which is wonderful. And it's just kind of a shifting landscape. Again, rarely do I dedicate 8 hours to one thing, right, one topic. It's sort of like we are all doing, and it's juggling, a lot of juggling.
So the scientists here are applying for grants, they're carrying out grants that maybe they've already been awarded, they're managing collections day-to-day, they're managing the exhibits day-to-day. Tell me a little bit about how you connect the dots, so to speak, for those scientists every day.
Yeah, that's a great question. So I want to make sure that I'm supporting them and the whole science enterprise. So all the collection managers, the scientific curators, the curatorial assistants, so that's a lot of people. But it starts with the curators and the heads of section. So I check in with them mostly to see how they are accomplishing goals we may have talked about, what the stumbling blocks are, and how we can problem solve if there are some issues that we need to work around. Mm-hmm. So those are the general themes of our interactions. And of course, as you would expect, every section, every collection has a different array of concerns, problems, successes, you know, accomplishments. So again, it's pretty challenging, but I check in with the curators. I like visiting with the collection managers too. I love going into the collections. Mm-hmm. And these days, not many people are around. There's usually one or two people there. And I feel like I get a personal tour in a way mm-hmm. these days. Yeah.
That's great. So you have your own field of study and research. Tell me a little bit about that.
Well, I'm a forest ecologist, and I study a variety of things, including forest insects and forest pests and forest pathogens and disturbance like fire and wind disturbance. So some of the research projects I'm involved in now include looking at forests that have been damaged by winds and how they develop over time, which species are coming back, are they the same species we've had before in the overstory, and if they are, that's interesting, what are the patterns of growth like, if they're not, what's going on. And over time, the last several decades, forests and all ecosystems have changed a lot, right, including with invasive species, let's say. So we may predict as ecologists what's going to happen in an ecosystem, but we're never good at that, especially in the last century or two centuries really, in a way during the Anthropocene, because there's been such change in species, basically species maybe becoming extinct, and invasive species, as I said, and patterns of activity of humans. So the science of nature has become more and more difficult to predict in my field and in all of our fields. That's why something like a collection, like a museum, is so valuable in a contemporary sense. We think about it being just a storage place of cool stuff, but no, we use it now in contemporary research to help inform, to help us understand what's going on over the decades and over the centuries. So this is a little snapshot of a lot of the different kinds of research I've been doing over the years, which all involves change, actually.
I love that you are talking about museums kind of having a new purpose now. Like you said, people see them as a place where we sort of store things and you can come and visit them. But it's really fascinating to learn that nowadays, in current times, we are able to take these collections and learn something and even work on the future and what's going to happen next.
I do learn something new every time I walk through an exhibit. So I'm picking on like a visitor's persona when I walk through exhibits and go through gallery spaces. I'm just like, I didn't know that. Oh. So it's wonderful. So
yeah. Right?
So this is a great environment to continue learning.
That's wonderful. Thank you so much.
Certainly.